Good afternoon, everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the computer organization subject, unit 4. So in this computer organization, we are having some content. So those contents are called peripheral devices, input-output interface, asynchronous data transfer, nodes of transfer, priority interrupt, direct memory access, input-output processor, serial communication. So these are the different topics which is available in the fourth unit. So now I'm going to discuss about the first topic, that is peripheral device. Okay, so what is mean by peripheral device? So in this we having some contents, that is monitor and keyboard, printer. In printer we having three types, that is Desi wheel printers, dot matrix printers, laser printers, and third one is magnetic tape, next magnetic disc. So these are the different contents available in the peripheral devices. Now coming to the brief explanation of the peripheral device. So what is mean by peripheral device? In this peripheral device we having input and output devices. In this we having input and output devices attached to the computers are called peripherals. So what is mean by peripheral here? Input and output devices attached to the computer are also called peripherals. So examples are keyboard, display units and printers. So these are the examples of the peripheral devices. So in peripherals that provide the auxiliary storage, this peripheral will provides the auxiliary storage for the system or magnetic disks. So what is the peripheral, what the peripheral provides? It provides the auxiliary storage for the system or magnetic disk and tapes. So peripherals are electrochemical. Okay, peripherals are electrochemical and electromagnetic devices of some complexity. Okay, so in this peripheral we have some contents we told now only, that is called monitor and keyboard. So what is mean by monitor and keyboard? So monitor is, there are monitor and keyboard, both are things we know commonly, so we are using daily in our life. Okay, so what is mean by that? So there are different types of video monitors and but the most popular use of cathode ray tube, CRT, and CRT contains the electronic gun. This CRT contains the electronic gun that sends an electronic beam of a phosphorescent. Okay, the in this CRT diagram we have seen in the first year, ma. So what is that? The most popular use of cathode ray tube, CRT. This cathode ray tube contains an electronic gun that sends an electronic beam to a phosphorescent. Okay, so the phosphorescent screen in front of the tube, the beam can be deflected horizontally and vertically. So what is mean by monitor and keyboard, ma? So we having the different types of video monitors. So most popularly we are using a cathode ray tube. So this cathode ray tube contains the electronic gun. So that this electronic gun will sends the electronic beam to a phosphorescent screen in front of the tube. So the beam can be deflected horizontally and vertically. So in this we having some characteristic features in keyboard and monitor. So a display device is a cursor that marks the position in the screen. A display device. So in this monitor and keyboard I have some features, that is display. The display device is a cursor. So that marks the position in the screen where the next character will be inserted. The cursor can be moved to any position in the screen. The cursor can be moved in any position, in any point of the screen. So what cursor is? Nothing but through mouse. So by using the mouse, we will move the arrow mark in the different position on the screen. Okay, so whatever the things I want to click, I can easily click that. That will be move. The arrow mark is not, that is a cursor. The cursor will be move each and every point of the screen. Okay, so this cursor can be moved at any position of the screen, to a single character, the beginning of a word or any line. So edit the keys, add and delete information based on the cursor position. So we can edit the options and we can edit the words and we can delete the information by using the cursor position. The display terminal can operate in a single character mode where the computer simultaneously. So this is called the monitor and keyboard. So what is nothing but peripheral devices? Peripheral devices is nothing but the two devices, that is input and output devices, which is attached to the computer, that is called the peripherals. So in this example, now only I told that is keyboard, display unit and printers. These are the examples. So next to magnetic and keyboard, what is mean by magnetic and keyboard? We are using the cathode ray tube. So we are having the so many different types of video monitors, but we are mostly popularly using the cathode ray tube. So it contains the electronic gun, so that sends the electronic beam to a phosphorescent screen in front of the beam. Okay, so that can be deflected horizontally and vertically. Okay, so this is called the monitor. And display keyboard is nothing but in the keyboard only we having the mouse. So okay, now cursor. The cursor will be moves. The cursor will be marks on the screen where the next character will be inserted. The cursor can be move any position of the screen, and single character being the word. Okay, so we can edit and add the and delete the information on the screen by using the cursor position. Okay, so this is called the keyboard. Okay, so cursor. Okay, next coming to the second one is a printer. What is mean by printer? Printer provides permanent record on paper of computer output data and text. So printer is now what? So whatever the information available in the computer, that can be printed in the paper. Okay, so that is called the printer. The printer is nothing but it provides the permanent record. We are going to I need some material from the internet. So I will give the printer option, print option, that will be printed in the material. So that will be safely used by the persons. Okay, so this printer provides the permanent record on paper of a computer output data or text. So there are three basic types of character printers. They say wheel printers, dot matrix printers, laser printers. So what is mean by these three types? So first one is wheel printers. So what is the use of this? So this wheel printer contains a wheel. This Desi wheel printers contains the wheel with the character placed along the circumference. Okay, so to print a character, the wheel rotates. So if you want to print the character, okay, print the character, we having the wheel in that. Okay, that wheel will be rotates to the proper position, and energized magnet then press the letter against the ribbon. Okay, na? So then the letter will be printed on the paper. Okay, so this is called wheel printer. Okay, so what is mean by they say wheel printer? We having one wheel that will be pressed. So that wheel will be the wheel with the character placed along the circumference to print the character. If you want to print the character, the wheel will be rotates to a proper position to energy magnet. Then it presses the letter against the ribbon. Okay, so this is the Desi wheel printer. Okay, next coming to dot matrix. So what is mean by dot matrix? In this dot matrix is nothing but, so we know that already matrix printers. Okay, so what is mean by dot matrix? So in this dot matrix printers contain dot matrix printer contains a set of dots along the printing mechanism. So in this printing mechanism, we having the set of dots. So okay, now so that is called the dot matrix. Okay, in this we are having example that is 5x7 dot matrix printer. So we are going to set that 5x7 in the matrix printer that prints the IT characters per line has 7 horizontal lines. So whatever the we have set the value that is 5x7 dot matrix. So that prints the 80 characters per line. For a 7 horizontal IT characters per line has 7 horizontal lines each line consisting of 400 dots. Okay, each consisting of 5x80 that is 400 dots. So this is called the dot matrix. Next is third one is a laser printer. What is mean by laser printer? A laser printer uses a rotating photographic drum that is used to imprint the character images. Okay, so this is called the laser printers. Next coming to magnetic tape. So what is mean by magnetic tape? That these magnetic tapes are used mostly for storing the files of data. So it is very cheap and slowest method for storing the information. Okay, and the main advantages of this magnetic tape is removing the, whenever it is not in work, not in use, we can remove the tapes. So this is one facility, or we can say it is an advantage of the magnetic tapes. Next coming to magnetic disc. What is mean by magnetic disc? In this magnetic disc, we are moving the read and write mechanism to attack in a magnetized surface. Discs are used mostly for bulk storage of programs and data. So in this magnetic disc, we are going to in this magnetic disc we are having the read and write mechanism, and it has a bulk storage space in order to store the programs and data. So this is called the magnetic tapes and magnetic disc. So in this peripheral device, we are having these types of contents, that is monitor and keyboard, printer. In the printer, we are having three types of printers, that is Desai wheel printers, so dot matrix printers, laser printers. So these are the three printers we are having. Next, magnetic tape and magnetic disc. So these are the four contents available in the peripheral devices. So next, coming to the input output devices. So input output interface. So before going to explain that, we are having some small table here. This is the ASCII code. ASCII means what? American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So this is a binary code. We can say it is a 0, 1. These values are called 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. A, B, C, D, E, F. This like we are representing. Okay. So these values are representing in whatever the values we are having. So that values can be represented in the binary form. That is 0, 1, 2, 3. This like. Okay. So these are the explanation. These are the representation of the code. Okay. Next, these are the symbols which are we are going to use in the system, computer system. Okay. So next, coming to the input and output interface. So what is mean by input and output interface? Input and output interface provides a method for transferring the information between internal storage and external input output devices. So what is the main use of input and output interface? It provides a method for transferring the information between the internal storage and external input output devices. So this is called input output interface. Peripherals connected to the computer need special communication. What are the peripherals means what? So peripherals is nothing but what ma? Now only I said input and output are connected to the attached to the computer. So these peripherals are connected to the computer need a special communication links for interfacing them with a central processing unit. So where is the central processing? This is the central processing unit. So these are the keyboard and display terminal, printer in this diagram. See this diagram. So in this diagram, we having the processor. This processor is called central processing unit, and we are having the keyboard and display terminal, printer, magnetic disc and magnetic disc. So these are the devices which is connected to the interface. So these interfaces are connected to the input output bus. So for this is the data, this is the address, this is the control. This will be control the complete communication. This is, it will be provide the address and it will be the data. Okay, so these are the three things available in the processor. So what we are doing here, so the whatever the peripherals are is there that are connected to you, connected to a computer, need a special communication links for interfacing them with a central processing unit. The purpose of communication link is to resolve the difference that existing between the central computer and each peripherals. So okay, so we having some major differences. There are peripherals or electromechanical and electromagnetic devices. So in these peripherals we are using the electromechanical and electromagnetic device, and their manner of operation is different from the operations of the CPU. So whatever the operations we are having in the CPU and memory, the peripherals is very different. So okay na, the operations of the peripherals is very different when compared to CPU and memory. So these peripherals are electromechanical and electromagnetic devices that are their manner of operation is different from the operation of CPU and memory. So which are electronic device. Therefore, a conversion of a signal values may be required. So the data transfer rate. Data transfer rate means what? The data transfer rate of peripherals is usually slower than the transfer rate of the CPU, and consequently, a synchronization mechanism may be needed. So data codes and formats. So what is mean by data codes and formats? So in this data codes, in the data code. Data codes and formats, peripherals differ from word format in the CPU and memory. So next to operating mode, operating modes of peripherals are different from each other, and each must be controlled so as not to disturb the operation of other peripherals connected to the CPU. So this is called the four different major differences are there in the input output interference. Okay, so this is the input and output interface. This is the diagram of the connection of input output buses bus to input output devices. So this is the input output bus, and these are the devices, input output devices, keyboard and display terminal, printer, magnetic disk, magnetic tape. These are the input output devices which is connected to the input output bus. Okay, so this is the input output interface. Next, coming to in this input output interface, we have to resolve these differences. Computer system include special hardware components between the CPU and peripherals to survive the synchronize all input and output transfers. These components are called interface units. Okay, so in the input output bus, this input output bus and interface modules, this is the interface modules, this is the input output bus, and this is the interface modules. So input output bus consists of data lines, address lines and control lines. So what we are contains the in the input output bus contains data line, address line, control lines. So next, coming to magnetic. So magnetic disk, printer, magnetic terminal, display terminal are employed in practically any general purpose computer. Magnetic tape is used in some computers for backup storage. So what is the three things we are having? Printer, display terminal, and magnetic disk. These three things are mainly used for general purpose of computer. This magnetic tape only used for some backup storage, which is used in computers for backup the storage. So this is the second point. Next, each peripheral device has associated with a interface unit. So these are the peripheral devices, these are associated with it and interface units. This interface is called the interface units. Okay, so each interface decodes this is one interface, this is second, third, fourth. These are the four interfaces. Each interface will be decodes the address and control received from input output bus, interrupts them for the peripherals and the processor. Each peripheral has its own controller that operates the particular electromechanical device. Okay, so this is the peripherals which is controlled by the particular electromechanical device. So in this input output bus from the processor is attached to all the peripherals interface to communicate with a particular device. The processor places a device address on bus, an address decoder that monitors the address lines. Okay. So in this diagram, the interface detects its own address. It activates the path between the bus line and the device that it controls. All peripherals whose address does not correspond to the address in the bus are disabled by the interface. So this is called the input-output interface. So this is the complete explanation of this diagram. Okay. So what are the things I am explaining in this input-output interface? This is the explanation of this diagram. Okay. So next coming to input-output commands. So what is meant by input-output commands? In this input-output commands, we are having four types of commands that our interface may receive. They are classified as control, status, data output and data input. So what is meant by control command? So a control command is issued to activate the peripherals and to inform it what to do. So control command, what will we do? So we having the control command. So what the use of that control command? That will be issues the command to the peripheral devices. What is the peripheral devices here? Keyboard, printer, magnetic tape, magnetic disk. These are the different types of peripheral devices. So this command will be, control command will be issued a command to the peripheral device and inform what to do. Okay, for example, a magnetic tape unit may be instructed by backup the tape. So I'm giving the instruction. For example is, I'm giving the instruction to the magnetic tape in order to back up the tape by one record. So to rewind the tape or to start the tape moving in the forward direction. So if you want to back up the tape, I will giving the instruction to the magnetic tape to back up the tape in one record. Okay, and to rewind the tape to backspace the tape by one record, and to rewind the tape or to start the tape moving in the forward direction. So this is the example of the control command. Control command means what? We are giving the instructions to that. So that instructions will be taken by that, and they will be follow that instruction, and they will maintain that instructions. Okay, that is called the control command. Next is status. What is mean by status? A status command is used to test various status conditions in the interface and peripheral. So interface means what? So whatever the diagram I am having here, this is the diagram, this is the interface, and next to what they say, that is the peripherals. So interface is nothing but this is. So these are the things we are having, the interfaces. So in the downside, below the interface, we are having some devices, that is keyboard and display terminal, printer, magnetic disk. These are the peripheral devices. Okay, so what they are saying in the status command is used to test the various status conditions in the interface and the peripherals. So whatever the status available in the interface or peripherals, that is called the status command. Next coming to example of the status. The computer may wish to check the status of the peripheral before a transfer is initiated. Okay, so that is the example of the status. Next, output data. So a output data command causes the interface to respond by transferring data from the bus into one of its register. So output data is nothing but, so the data, one of the register that gets the command response. Okay, data output command causes the interface to respond the transferring data from the bus into its registers. That is called output data. Next, coming to input data. So, coming to input data. So the input data data input command is a opposite of the data output. So it is opposite to the output data. Okay. So what in this case the interface receives? The interface receives an item of data from the peripherals and place it in the buffer register. So in the output data, what we are doing? The output data output command causes the interface to respond by transferring data from the bus into one of its register. So okay, we are transferring the data from the bus into one of its register. So that is the output data. Input data is nothing but input data command is completely opposite to the data output. So in this case, what we are doing? Interface receives an item of data from the peripheral and places it in the buffer register. Okay. So this is completely opposite to the output data. So this is called the input-output commands. So next to coming to input input output versus memory bus so there are three ways that computer bus can be used to communicate with memory and input output. So what we are having the three ways in order to communicate with memory and input output. Okay, so what is that first one? Use two separate buses. We are going to use the two separate buses, one for memory and another for input output. So we are using the two separate buses. One is for memory and another is for input output. Use one common bus for both memory and input output, but have separate control lines for each. So we are using the one common bus, okay, for both the. So we have three ways. First way is we are taking the two separate buses. Each one is memory and another is input output. So another way is using one common bus for both the memory and input output but have separate control lines for each. So both having the separate control lines. So both are using the common bus. Okay, that is memory and input, both are using the common bus, but they have the separate control lines for each. So this is the second way. Third way is use one command bus for memory and input output with common control lines. Okay, so we are using the common bus also. For memory and in memory and input using the common bus also and common control lines also. Okay, so these are the three ways which is used in the input output versus memory bus. Okay, next example of the input output interface. So it consists of two data registers called ports. We are having the two data registers called ports: a control register, a status register, bus buffer, and timing and control circuits. So what is the example of the input output interface? It contains the consists of two data registers called the ports. So a control register, a status register, bus buffer, and timing and control circuits. So the interface communicates with communicates with the CPU through the data bus. So what we are having? We are having some interfaces. That interface will be communicated to the CPU, central processing unit. So through the data bus. So the chip select and register inputs determine the address assigned to the interface. So this is the example of the input output versus memory bus. So input output read and write are two control lines. We are having the in the input output we are input output we are having the two control lines, that is read and write. So that specifies the input output respectively. The four registers communicate directly. We have four registers that communicate directly with the input output devices attached to the interface. So the input output data to and from the device can be transformed into either port A or port B. Okay, the interface may operate with an output device or with an input device or with a device that requires both input and output. So a magnetic disk unit transfer the data. A magnetic disk unit that transfer the data into either port A and port B. Okay, so the interface may operate with an output device or within an input device or with a device that requires both input and output. So a magnetic disk unit transfers data in both directions but not at the same time. So the interface can be bidirectional line. Okay, So that is called the magnetic disk unit. So control is sent to the control register register. Status information is received from the status register, and data are transformed to and from ports is always via common data bus. So the control register receives the control information from CPU by loading appropriate bits into the control register. The interface and the input output devices attached to it can be placed in a variety of operating modes. So the port A may be defined as an input port and port B as a output port. So these bits in the status register are used for status condition and for recording errors that may occur during the data transfer. So we are having examples in the input output input output interface. So what is the status bit may indicate that port A has received a new data item from the input output device. So another bit is the status register may indicate that a parity error has occurred during the transfer. The circuit enables the chip select CS input. When the interface is selected by the address bus, the two registers select inputs RS1 and RS0 are usually connected to the two least significant lines of the address bus. So this is the example of the input output interface. So next coming to isolated versus memory mapped. So what is mean by isolated? So the isolated input output and memory mapped input output. What is mean by isolated input output? So this isolated this isolated input output is nothing but separate address space for both memory and input output devices. For input output, both input and output devices, memory and input output devices, we are need a separate address space. Okay, separate memory and input output select lines needed. So small number of input output instructions commonly used. So this is the interface isolated input output. Memory. Next coming to memory mapped input output. So what is mean by memory mapped input output? A single address space both memory and input output devices. So we are having the single address. So for this isolated input, what we are having the separate addresses, address space for both memory and input output device. But in this memory mapped input output device, we are having the same a single address space for both the input output device and memory. So disadvantages of this is uses up valuable memory using the valuable memory address space. So next coming to input output modules or recognized registers treated as memory address. Same mechanism instructions used to access both memory and input output devices. Its example advantage is it allows the more efficient programming. So next coming to single read line and single write line needed. So commonly used. So these are the different things which is we have studied in the isolated input output versus memory mapped. So okay. So in this we having the diagram. This is the diagram of the input output interface which you have seen studied now. So this is the bus buffer. This is the bidirectional bus data bus. Bidirectional means two ways communication will be occurred. So this RMOs are bidirectional. So this is the bus buffer. This is a port register A, and this is the CS means next CS, and this is in this is CS chip select and RS1 and RS0, and these are the inputs. Register select, these are the two registers select the inputs, that is RS1 and RS0, and the next coming to RD and read and write and read, and this is the port A, port AB, the port control register, status register. Okay, so these are the two input output devices. This is the CPU and this is the table example of the input output interface unit. Here in this table we are having the chip selector, RS1 input and RS0 inputs. Okay, so register selected, none data bus in the high performance. So when I am registering that port, that is called register A, and port B register, control register, and status register. So this is the example of the input output interface unit. So next coming to synchronous data transfer. So in the next class we will discuss about the asynchronous data transfer. Okay, and we having some more topics in this. These are the destination initiated, handshaking. So these things, asynchronous serial transmission, communication interface, first in first out, and next modes of interface. So these are the things which is I'm going to explain in the next video class. So thank you for listening. So thank you everyone.